One West Magazine, One West Radio. It's your boy P Flicks. We live and in charge and doing it real big. It's Monday night. We got a special guest in the house, man. She is doing her thing. She out there in Arkansas holding it down for your nephew. She got a new book out right now, man. It's a collection of her, all of her poetry. You know what I'm saying? She knocked them out. It's called A Walk in My Shoes. We got Miss LaQuisha Malone in the house. How you doing, Miss Lady? Hey, I'm chilling. Now, first of all, thanks for taking the time to holler at One West Magazine.
You're welcome. I'm honored.
Now, tell us, now how did you get started as a writer?
Well, ever since before I could remember, you know, I've been writing. I grew up with paper and pencil in my hand, just writing down thoughts, drawing, all those type of things. So, I guess you can say it's just always been in me, you know?
Now, I read here that you said you also started off writing fiction stories. Tell us about those.
Oh, man. Yeah, about 12, 13 years old, got into fiction writing and things of that nature, mostly journaling, stuff that happened throughout my day, and, you know, hanging with the girls and all those things, and fictionalizing it up a little bit, making it spicy and stuff, and I started writing from there, and one day my mom was going through my room and she found my little journal and read everything in it and was like, oh my God, this is good. You
now, wait a minute, hold on. Now, you talking about your mom's found your journal and she read your journal. Ain't that against the law to be reading somebody's journal?
That is against the rules, man. And you know what I did? I ripped it all up.
Oh, you ripped it up.
I did. I felt like, you know, my thoughts, everything that was private was revealed and it was like, no, I can't have that. So I ripped it up, but I regret it to this day. Regret it. It was some good stuff.
Now, your book, A Walk in My Shoes, it's a collection of poetry. When did you make the transition to poetry? What made you decide to start doing that?
After that incident, you know, because when you're storytelling, you're being very detailed, it's easy to know who and what you're talking about if you make it personal. So from that point on, I began to write poetry. I had an English teacher who was a fan of my writing, and so she would do Shakespeare and all these different other people in poetry for English class, saying, you know, I did it just for you so you can expand yourself. And so I kind of liked what was going on, and I was like, hey, you're writing, you're still kind of telling a story, but they don't know who I'm talking about. So I stick to that for a while. So that's kind of how I got to that.
Now I can dig that. Now are there any poets out there that inspired you to also want to do your thing?
Dr. Maya Angelou, yes, loves her writing. So seeing what she could do, I knew that I could do that as well. You know, so I just kept writing. Sometimes I'll write 8 or 9 a day, just depending on what I was going through.
All day long. Rest in peace to Queen Angelou all day, man. Phenomenal woman. Now, A Walk in My Shoes. Now, tell us about the book, you know what I'm saying, and the inspiration behind it. How did you come up with that title, first of all?
Well, it came from my very first book. I wrote my first book in 2008, and it was called A New Pair of Shoes, Step in Mine. And I was not totally satisfied with the whole publishing process, so I always knew I wanted to redo it. And I say 6 years later, after 2 books, and I said, well, this third book come around, I'm going to redo the first one, you know, give a little bit more of myself. I'm going to do it this time so it can be real and raw. So that's kind of where it was. So I shortened my title down to just, you know, taking a walk in my shoes, a trip down memory lane with me and everything that I went through, you know, as far as teenagers and growing up and things of that nature. My goal was to showcase that even though you're young, your thoughts and your emotions and your feelings are real, you know. Yeah, so that's kind of where it come from.
Now, you also, you know, you're an entrepreneur. You're doing your thing. You got your publishing company, Strawberry Publications. Tell us about that right there.
Oh, man, yeah. Wonderful. Great. I've always wanted to start a company, and after my first experience of publishing, I was so unsatisfied. I took about 3 years off, you know, no writing, really doing nothing but researching. And I figured out how to, you know, get the book part down myself. And from there, when I did my second book and it got a great response, and they were like, oh, this here is better than the first book. I said, said, well, I did that all by myself. That's my baby. And it was like, yeah, you know, can you help me? Can you help this person? And I began to help people. I was like, wait a minute. I'm doing everything like a publisher. I might as well start my own company. So I took another 3 years and began to research a little bit more about how to do the business and company side of everything. And in September of 2013, I said, it's time to launch this thing and get it together.
There it is there. Once again, it's One West Magazine, One West Radio, man. We holding it down with a very talented author. You know what I'm saying? LaQuisha Malone. She's in the house. Now tell us, of all of the, now a walk in my shoes, of all of the poems that's in there, that's in the book, what's your favorite one and why?
Oh, that's kind of hard because they're all so personal. So that's kind of hard to just narrow it down to one.
If you were stuck on the island and you had your book, Lord. And you had your book in your hand, they told you you can rip out one page, that's all you get, which one would it be?
If I have to say that, I would say it would be First Impression. I would go just thinking off of that, it would have to be First Impression. That would be it.
Why First Impression?
I wrote that gearing off of your first impression of meeting someone or seeing someone and your thoughts and your feelings of what's going down with all of that. And then it became even more personal for me when I bought a book from Tupac Shakur and realized he had a poem titled The Same Thing, kind of related to the same thing. And as much as I love him, I was like, yeah.
The rose that grew from concrete.
That's it. So I saw that and I was like, yeah, I already love this guy. So look what we got in common. So it means something more than just what I wrote, you know.
Now dig that. Now you're also a model as well. Tell us about your modeling career.
Man, I started that in 2010, not thinking that I could even do it. And I got picked up by a lady from Tam Modeling with Terry McGill out of Texas and started, you know, trying to do a little work for them. And then after a while, I don't know, it just seemed like certain small things began to happen. I did some photography for a couple of studios and things of that nature. And then I was featured as Babe of the Month for one of Ty Burns' little magazine, Street Jams. And it just kind of go from there, and I kind of just do stuff here or there. But my love is writing, of course.
Now tell me this. Now this is One West Magazine. Now I'm a hardcore journalist, and I ask the tough questions all day long. Now tell us about, I mean, as a model, you know what I'm saying, as an African-American woman, tell us about your experience and what do you think about the fashion industry and the modeling industry and about sisters getting on the runway right now. What do you think about the state of the industry as it stands right now?
As it stands right now, I would say that, I mean, I can't speak for the forefront, but behind the scenes, we can do better sometimes, especially when it comes to people of different shapes and sizes. You know, they're getting a little better with that, yeah, but it could be, you know, we could be publicized a little bit better. One of my experiences I've had as a model trying to make it and things like that, with the curves that I do have, is certain things I can't get into. But then there's like a whole other world of things they want me into, which is things that I'm not comfortable with at the moment. So it's like, wow, why portray myself this way over here in this light? That's not where I'm trying to go. But because of certain curves and things you have going on, you know, sometimes they shun you away from certain things that you really want to do in modeling, you know, in the upright way.
Now I can do
if you understand.
Now, do you think that there's enough opportunities out there for would-be black fashion models to get on the runway?
I would say, yeah. It's so many people now who are making a way for models of like us, you know, who are curvy and things of that nature. Because normally, you know, you see the really, really, really small and skinny people on the runway, but you're starting to see a little bit more curves and things like that on the runway, so I think it's getting better in that way. Yeah, I would agree.
So, what would be your definition of a plus size model? Like when do you get to the point to where that you're, I just saw an ad, you know, a Calvin Klein ad, and it had this real petite chick on there. And she and she was saying that she was pushing the line as a plus size model. There ain't no way in heck that she could have been a plus size model. So I'm just wondering, you know, in our culture, at what point are you considered a plus size model? You know, so people know.
Right. Well, believe it or not, at my size, I'm considered kind of like a plus size. Like I said, certain things I can't get involved in because of the certain type of curves that I have. So I don't know the exact size, but I know that it's no longer just double digits. They're considered plus models anymore. You know, you got some single digits, they'll say, yeah, that's a plus model over there too. You know, it has happened, so. I can't put a finger on the exact size, but it's ridiculous when you see a plus size model and you're like, wait a minute, I'm looking at me and I'm looking at her and man.
Yeah, I can dig it, you know. Now, you know, I'm really analytical about things like that, so I had to ask. Now, you're also a public speaker, you know. Tell us about your experiences as a public speaker.
Man, all for the kids. I love trying to speak life into children and our youth of today. So one of the things I have been doing is, you know, getting involved in, like, universities and things of that nature. So, and gearing toward high school so that I could, you know, talk to them. My next novel that releases over the summer of next year is a teenage fiction. It's geared toward things that I know, you know, teenagers go through, especially where I work and from my own experiences. You know, it's a lot of things that these kids are, they need help and guidance, you know. So for me, that's kind of how I got more into public speaking. I even did, like, workshops for the youth in creative writing so they could write their feelings out. And I did it for, like, 3 years in my community. And everything is just geared toward the babies, you know. That's what we need to reach. We really need to reach them, you know. It's getting hard right now, so somebody needs to reach them, try to.
There it is there. Once again, this is One West Magazine, One West Radio, man. We are live and doing it real big with Miss LaQuisha Malone, the author of her new collection of her hot poetry, A Walk in My Shoes. Now, if fans want to grab it, get a hold of that book, how do they get a hold of your book?
It's selling on Amazon, anywhere online, Barnes & Noble, Borders, and, you know, Kindle. Yeah. Anywhere online. And if you're in the Michigan area, then you can go to Blackstone. They stock it on the shelf. So shout out to Blackstone Bookstores over in Michigan for stocking my title. And matter of fact, they've got my author title from Strawberry Publications as well. They have her book. I gotta send a shout out to Miss Pamela Wright. She's right now on the bestseller list, so that's from my company. I'm proud of that.
All day long. And if fans want to find Miss LaQuisha Malone online, how do they find you online?
You can hit me up on Facebook at LaQuisha Malone. You can hit me at Twitter at LaQuisha M or LovelyPoet79. You can find me on Instagram at LovelyPoet79. And you can find me in places like that and Pinterest.
Now, Miss LaQuisha Malone, are you a fan of music?
I am a fan of music.
Now,
I love all type of art, so yes.
Now, this is One West Radio, and we are in the mix. Why don't you bring us into our next joy? What do you want to hear?
Oh, man, you put me on the spot of music like that.
Hey, that's what we
doesn't
do here.
Doesn't matter what era or what year, because, you know, I'm a little old school. I'm in my 30s right now. So.
Well, it's all about you right now, so whatever you want to hear, that's what we finna put in the mix.
Oh, really?
And you do know that.
Well, it doesn't matter what song it is, because I love it all. I would love to hear something from Tupac, if that's okay, you know.
That's nothing, you know what I'm saying?
That's not too bad for you.
And I'm finna hook that up for you. This is One West Magazine, One West Radio. We got Miss LaQuisha Malone in the house. Make sure you guys go out there, grab her book, A Walk in My Shoes. Y'all gotta support my sister. And you do know that. Thanks for coming out, Miss LaQuisha.
Thank you for having me.
All day. One West Radio, we in the mix.
Machiavellianist, Illuminati, all through your body. The blows like a 12-gauge shotty.
Feel me? And God said he should send his one begotten son to lead the wild into the ways of the man. Follow me.
killer, but don't push me. Revenge is like the sweetest joy next to getting pussy. Picture paragraphs unloaded, wise words being quoted. Beat the weakness in the rap game and sold it. Bow down, pray to God, hoping that he's listening. See a nigga that's coming for me, my diamonds when they glisten. Now pay attention, bless me, please, Father. I'm a ghost, and he's killing fields. Hail Mary, catch me if I go. Let's go deep inside the solitary mind of a madman. Screams in the dark, evil lurks, enemies see me flee. Activate my hate, let it break, till I'm flaming. Set trip, empty out my clip, never stop to aim. Some say the game is all corrupted, fucked in this shit. Stuck, niggas is lucky if we bust out this shit. Plus, mama told me never stop until I bust a nut. Fuck the world if they can't adjust. It's just a swell. Hail Mary, come with me. Hail Mary, nigga, run quick, see what do we have here now? Do you wanna ride or die? La da 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 da. Come with me. Hail Mary, nigga, run quick, see what do we have here now? Centuries is back with promise makers. Never realized the precious time that bitch niggas is wasting. Institutionalized, I live my life a product made to crumble. Must do hard and for a smile, way too crazy to be humble. We ballin', catch me father please, cause I'm ballin'. In the liquor store, that's the Hennessy I hear callin'. Can I get some more? Hell till I reach hell, I ain't scared. Mama checking in my bedroom, I ain't there. I got a head with no screws in it. What can I do? One life to live, but I got nothing to lose, just me and you. On a one-way trip to prison, selling drugs, we all wrapped up in this living. Like the Stubbs, to my homeboys and Clinton Max, doing they bid. Raise hell to this real shit, and feel this. When they turn out the lights, I'll be there in the dark. Look eternal through my heart. Now Hail Mary, nigga, come with me. Hail Mary, nigga, run quick, see. What do we have here now? Do you wanna ride or die? La da 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 da.
Coming with slugs.
Peep the whole scene and whatever's going on around me. Brain kinda cloudy, smoked out, feeling rowdy, ready to wet the party up. And whoever in that motherfucker, nasty new street slugger. My heat, Zeke suckers on the regular, mashing in a stolen black act. Integra, cock back, sticky seconds to the draw. That's when I'm dead and your feet first. You got a nice gap, but my heat's worse. From a thug to preaching church, I gave you love. Now you eating dirt, needing work. And I ain't the nigga to put you on, cause word is born. When I was broke, I had to hustle till dawn. That's when the sun came up. It's only one way up, hold your head, stay up. To all my niggas, get your pay and wait up.
If it's on, then it's on. We rake, we breaks, outlaws on the paper chase. Can you relate to the shit I don't got? Be the shit I gotta take. Dealing with fate, hoping God don't want the gate. If it's on, then it's on. We rake, we breaks, outlaws on the paper chase. Can you relate to the shit I don't got? Be the shit I gotta take. Dealing with fate, hoping God don't close the gate.
Traveling on this weary road, sometimes life could be a heavy load, but we ride, riding like a bullet.
Hail Mary, Hail Mary,
we won't worry, everything will hurry. Bring like a balloon tree. We won't worry, everything will curry. Yes, we're free like a bird in the tree. We're running from the penitentiary. This is the time for we liberty. Hail Mary, Hail Mary.
Westside, Outlaws, Machiavelli the Don, Solo.